Why am I smiling like this? I'm all happy. Right. If you've kind of kept up with my inane dribble and everything else, you know, and you kind of, by the way, it's boiling hot, you know. But if you've kept up with my inane dribble and kind of seen what my favourite beers and things are, you'll know how I talk about Saddlers for a start. I go, it's like synonymous with the name. Straight away I'll go, Saddlers, the genius brewers. And I always remark on them as the same because I kind of think there's certain people that do little genius jobs in there, and they're one of them, you know. And they really do kind of them little subtle differences that make a big, big difference. One of my favourites of theirs, actually my favourite of theirs, and they do some glorious ones, is the Mud City Stout, but that's kind of, I don't know what that is, 5.4 or 6 or something. It's kind of the mid-range region in it, you know. I can't remember the exact ABV of it, but it's a mid-range region, but it's brewed with lovely fresh vanilla pods all thrown in there. And what else have we got? You got all the kind of the chocolate stouts. Cocoa pods have you got or something? I'll tell you on here. Wait a minute. Right, Imperial Stout. Mud City first. I'll read the top. Imperial Stout, a style first brewed in London in the 18th century and exported to the former Baltic province of Imperial Russia. Brewed strong and full of character to survive the brutal cold and long distances travelled. It was said that the Empress of Russia, Catherine the Great, was enthusiastic for Imperial Russian Stout. She was proud she could drink as much as this of this strong sweet beer as any Englishman. Good girl. Hey, my kind of girl. Mud City, dark and delicious stouts brewed with raw cocoa. So raw cocoa beans, where are we? Wheat and vanilla pods, flaked oats and a blend of dark malts, molasses, treacle and soft licorice, are rounded with a dark coffee bean and honeyed nut character, sweet vanilla, chocolate. I ain't gonna read the rest, it's like all notes and stuff, but basically you got cocoa, you got vanilla. What you're talking to is chocolate, because vanilla and cocoa are what make chocolate. Without the fat and the salt, you know, you get the fat and the salt and all that in there, and the milk and everything, you know, but you're gonna get all that out of the beer, out of the malts and everything in the beer. Right. Let's go for this. I'm gagging to go for this. By the way, we're right up at the 9.9 region. Now, these are the kind of dizzy heights of normal brewing. You know, I know they do that ice distillation and God knows what, the people like your BrewDog and people like that are doing. This is kind of like normal brewing. You'll get up to 12s and things maximums. I think there's some that are 14 even, but you get up there with certain champagne and Belgian yeast and things like that. Anyway, I do digress. Let's get this out into me. I've only got a big glass here at the moment, so you kind of will have to go with me on it. I haven't got a kind of Saddler's glass, but we work with it. I've got a GBBF glass, is what I've got. Very plain crown, but doing its job. This is what does its job, is the rubber seal stuff inside. It's kind of inactive with everything apart, and just kind of seals it up nicely. and the actual metal is just to hold it on. It doesn't interact with it. Now, not kind of sure if you're going to be looking at a head here. As happens, I've poured one in because I've kind of not expecting one. We've got any bottle conditioning? Do you know what? It doesn't really matter. It's dark enough you won't notice it. Right, let's sniff the bowl. Oh, cracky. Right, the head has died down very quickly. As I said, you're probably not going to be holding on to a head for a long while. You've got a high ABV. You know, we're not putting E405 in or nothing like that. It's pure brewing. So the head's going to go kind of die down quickly. But what you've got in there is you've got carbonation, you've got a healthy drink. When the head dies down quickly, just look at the reflection coming off the light. You see, just little, like, looks like raindrops on the top, but tiny miniature. And it's really pretty to see. And of course you can kind of twirl one in. I've just spilled a little bit that down there. But you can twirl one in. Give yourself like a little bit of head again. And off it goes again. Tick, 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 tick. Right. Get a sniff. Personally, I don't like head in beer. You know, I've said this ages ago. And I've started pouring heads in beers because it's by popular demand. And also, brewers take time to brew head into beers and that, you know. And they kind of take time to make beers clear and all that, you know. So bottle conditioned beer, you're supposed to pour it all careful and everything else, which is what I do. But when I'm pouring it for myself, I go wallop, get it in there. And also I pour it carefully so that I don't get ahead, but I get the yeast in at the end of it and that, and it all sits smearing and clouding down as it goes. But that's my personal preferences. You drink it how you want to. And don't let anyone tell you otherwise. The only reason I don't drink it how I want to is because it's kind of something the brewers brew into the drinks. So I've got to show that to you guys, what they're putting into it. And also, it's by popular demand. You get people want to see the head in there, you know. So I'll give them what they want, you know. Right. Let's have a sniff. Cool. Right, you've got, what's the dark? It's like a dark caramel in there, like a burnt caramel. Coffee beans, you've got kind of like Arabica coffee. Sweet, you know, big blackstrap molasses there, big. Big hefty, you can almost see it doing that thing when it goes backwards and forwards like that. There's something about watching, I've gone off again, and there's something about watching treacle or something like that being poured when it does all that at the end, wags its tail on it, you know, and leaves little marks. I'm fascinated by that. I can sit and watch it for ages just going in a little dreamland and, all right, mouth open. Weird, isn't it? And flames as well. When you're sitting there, you're just starting the barbecue up and there's flames licking up. Little things please little minds, I suppose, isn't it? You've got big old plummy, pruny notes in there. Oh, you can smell that alcohol. That's kind of punchy, that is. Almost smells like it's been in whiskey barrels or something. It's got that smoky sort of earthy kind of woody note to it. But that might be the vanilla, kind of vanilla pods. They've got a slight woodiness to them. If you're throwing the whole pod in, not just scraping it out, and, you know, don't throw the pods away. Listen, just a quick note. If you're ever using vanilla and you scrape it out, all the little seeds out, and you use them, don't throw that pod away. Don't waste it. That's delicious. So chuck that in your little sugar bowl or something like that, or in your caster sugar or whatever. Just chuck it in your sugar bowl. And then chuck the next one in, and just leave them in there. They won't go off, they're all covered in sugar. And they'll really flavour that sugar up, it's delicious. I mean, I'm not allowed sugar, and so I don't have it in anything, pretty much. But if you're cooking with it and whatever else, or making your coffee or whatever, you know, lovely stuff. You got little hints of demerara sugar in there, funny enough as well. But those big old vanilla pods, big sort of woody vanilla pods, not quite like as smooth as ice cream, that sort of thing, but yeah, big vanilla pods, all the kind of the big woody bit, all like working hard for you as well. Right, we're going in. Cheers, everyone. Bottoms up. Chin chin. That is massive. Right, let's move over a bit here. That is awesome. That is bloody awesome. Now, it is Mud City Stout. I recognise it as Mud City Stout, but it's a planet apart. It is absolutely huge. Mud City Stout was really lovely, but it was 6.6, I think, upside down, if I remember. That is massive. I was going to kind of get a big old mouthful, but it went wallop. As soon as it got in there, it went wah! And you just like knocked her back with it. And I was completely knocked back as soon as I tasted that. That is really massive. Cool. That is glorious. In I go again. Cheers. Cool. Wow. Now, it reminds me of the Tuol Sword Milk, which is, I think it's a barrel-aged milk stout, if I'm not much mistaken. That is a glorious, glorious, glorious beer. And this is along them sort of lines as well. This is one of the most glorious beers I've had. Absolutely fantastic. It beats the Mud City Stout. It does. It's Jesus Christ. Cool. Excuse me. Right, let's have another go. Oh, all the things described on the nose, you've got all those big chocolate, even more milky sort of, not milk chocolate, but sort of less dark chocolate in there as well. You've got dark chocolate mixed in, kind of like marbled up with some lighter sort of milky chocolate, just you run the mill chocolate, but a good quality, kind of like a 30% cocoa sort of run. But you've got a big hefty sort of little flex of 70% in there as well. Not even right up to a hefty cocoa, 90%, some things like that. Excuse me. But amongst all that, you've got like little burnt cherries, almost. Not burnt, but really well done cherries. Excuse me. You've got currants in there. You've got prunes. You've got... you've got kind of dried strawberries. You've got coffee again. But a weird blend, yeah? You've got kind of Arabica and Robusta. You've got a smoothness. And then you've got a little edgy kick like that in there. Like kind of a little bastard boy, you know, one of them. Excuse my language. That is massive. You almost want a Sherpa to come with you and help you with that one. You won't get any though, but at least hold me up while I drink it. It's like that. Don't get me wrong, it's not hard going, because I want to belt it, but I'm like, whoa, take your time, really enjoy this. That is something else. Luckily, I've got another one as well. I was going to save it for when Dave comes down, but that might be gone. He's going to have to try and get one himself. No, do you know what? I'm too kind. I'm going to have a little share out. I've got a share out box that I've got with about a dozen beers in it. That I'm kind of, right, get that one down, yeah? You know, things like that. Where I've got sort of doubles of certain beers in it. So, yes. That one there is extraordinary. That is really bloody lovely, that is. Without a doubt, try it. Dun, 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 dun. try and bite and bloody love it. Without a doubt, that one. Without a doubt, you will you'll want that again. That's kind of one of those special beers that you want to have on your birthday, on Father's Day, some, you know, things like that, Christmas, any time when there's a special little you time, you know, when it's like, "Hey, Dad, I got you this. This is especially, you know, sit there one night when everyone's gone to bed and kind of just sit and enjoy it and enjoy a bit of you time." And that is one of those moments where you just sit and have a bit of you time. You've got your drink there, your little book and your telly and whatever music, whatever's on. Just relaxing. Ah. And you have a sip of that. Put it down again. Ah. That's lovely. I'm sad to see the bottom of that. But guys and girls, that is extraordinary. 9.9%. It's there to carry those big flavours. I always say, look, don't just drink alcohol for drinking alcohol's sake. It's there to feed the soul and not empty the mind. You know, it's there for purposes of lifting those beautiful flavours up, perking them up, and then giving them to you as a little gift. There you go. Boom, look what I've got you. And that's what alcohol's there for. It's kind of, it helps to push that straight into your tongue, you know. That is lovely. Cheers. Bottoms up. Chin chin. Do that as well. When you finish a glass, leave it up and breathe in. Fill your head up. You know, that is absolutely glorious. Cheers, everyone. See you in the next one. Don't be late. For the man to the brave, with a man for a world with a man.